One of the pathetic arguments atheists resort to try to prove that there is no intelligent design behind the great levels of order we see in nature ultimately, while preaching that with intelligently designed shitposts, which makes them hypocrites. One of these is that Occam's razor means there is no God, because God can't be a simple explanation, and if we can't understand it, then it must be wrong. It must be wrong. This is a very naive argument. First of all, Occam's razor, I don't know if that's how his name is spelled, but it doesn't matter because he's not important. Occam's razor is one, an assumption. There's no proof that something being more simple is necessarily closer to the truth. After all, my point number two, all complex things can be put in simple terms and vice versa. So if you think it's complicated, someone can word it in a way that's simple. Wasn't it Einstein who said that you don't understand something unless you can explain it in simple terms? Now, I'm not saying Einstein was as great as he's made out to be, but he would be right about that if he said that. So he's saying, he talks about some overrated so-called philosopher. I was subject to indoctrination attempts throughout my youth in public schools from second grade to university. And they made me read about people like Hume, who is forgettable, so, you know, I forgot about what he taught. And Nietzsche, I plan to do a video on Nietzsche, that piece of shit burning as you hear this. You know, Nietzsche ist tot, Gott ist groß. All these so-called philosophers, God says the wisdom of the world, that which is considered wise to heathens, is folly to the Creator. Like this nonsense. Some guy said that if something's not capable of being understood by simple people, then it must be wrong. Yeah, because truth depends on the ability of the simple-minded to grasp it. Yes, that's a very powerful argument. Now, I repeat this argument a lot because, one, it's concise, it's brief, gets to the point fast. Two, it's irrefutable. Three, it does the job of proving more than one thing at once. And so this proves that there is at least one God. And those atheists who deny one of the premises, the initial premise of freedom to think, are discrediting themselves, saying they're not thinkers. And they're also cucks in doing so, because they would justify whoever would rape their wife, because if there is no God, there is no great spirit, in which case we have no spirits from a great spirit, would be just bags of flesh, in which case nature made me do it would justify all evil. So atheists are worse than Nazis objectively. So this is another argument I wanted to cover, so got that out of the way.